Hello, it's Felonius the Wizard again, yapping about, well, mostly nothing. Today I'm going to talk about some social rules that I've found, or as I've known of for quite a while. And this is my culture, perhaps it's not yours. There are some things that are strange. Well, first of all, myself, I am a bit odd. When people say you need to do something, or you must do that, or you must do that, I always question why. I don't understand some of the rules that are talking about. I can take a simple one. In Sweden, it's very common to have plants in our windowsills. You have plants in every window. It's not like you are just choosing one or two windows and have them there because the sun is better that way. No. You have to have plants in every window. You must have. It's socially accepted to have windows filled with green stuff that you have to water and take care of the rest of your life or until you throw them out. I can't understand that. Why can't you have, like, I don't know, what do I have? I got some CD records in one window. I have some Pokemon figures in one window, just because I didn't know where to put them. I have, I got actually one plant. A plant that I took and started the day we divorced, me and my son's mother. I took a sapling and I planted that one. It's a very ugly tree, and I don't... Yes, it's a tree, actually. And I don't even know what the name is of that one. Oh, that's not socially accepted either. You must know every tree's name, or every plant, or whatever it is. And what do I have in my last window? I can't really remember. I think I put some books there lately. Yeah. And books, well, that's another one. You do have to have bookshelves. And shelves all over the camp. And you should have it in your living room. And in those bookshelves, you should have your children's photos, you should have your books, you should have porcelain figures, stuff that you have to do with it. It's just dusted. And the books, well, it's the books that you own. You just show people, look, these books I own. Yeah, right, have you read them? Not always, they don't. You don't have to read the books. All you have to do is show them for the people. It's a bragging thing, I suppose. I also have books. I think I have a row of 42 books, which is my first complete book collection of a series. It's a children's series from when I was a kid, and I really loved those books when I was 10 years old. So, now suddenly, when I'm older, I could get them all. There was only 42 of them, because both writers are dead, so they will get back and haunt me, I can tell you that. And those books are standing right behind, I think it's my PC games, I think I have them on that row, and the Game Boy Advance. No, it's the GameCube games. Yes, because they are in front. So you see, when you get into my room, my living room, you see that I am a gamer. Why? Because all my shelves are not filled with books, photos, or porcelain figures. They are games. There are board games on every shelf that I could think of. Except a few where I put some plastic models, model kits, that I just fixed. Yeah. But that's not socially accepted. And I can't understand why not. It's me. That's how I am. And I don't have any friends. Might that have something to do with each other? No. There are several other stuff that you must do or mustn't do. There are, for instance, you have to follow some sort of TV shows. We have something called the Eurovision Song Contest going on here in Sweden. And if you're not watching that, or our Swedish version of American Idol, or whatever it is that is putting on at the moment, you're not acceptable. You are out of the social network. Facebook is another one, but I'm not going into that one because that I don't know and understand. So, if you're not socially into what everyone else is, you are not. Well, you're not acceptable. And the funny thing is that I know for a fact that humans are social beings. We are a pack man. Sorry, pack thing. We are into packs. So, even if I'm not socially acceptable in my culture, I'm still a social being. And that clash totally. Wherever I go anywhere, suddenly I don't understand what people are talking about. We talked about sports last time. And sports is one of those things that, what's Eindhoven? What's Djurgården? I don't understand. Is that some sort of food? Perhaps? Pokemon? Perhaps? No? You should not talk about Pokemon. Whatever you do, do not talk about Pokemon. People are just going to look at you as you were totally crazy. There are probably several other stuff that you are not allowed to talk about because that's not socially acceptable. But who made those social rules? And when did they make these social rules? How come I missed it? Why can't I find these rules on the net? Why can't I find a book about them? Some sort of thing. There was some old books in the 50s about how to behave. But they were more or less built on the Christian rules we had back then. We don't have them anymore. So I can't really go to the Bible and watch why I should watch some TV shows and stuff. It's a bit strange, I must say. Well, that's me in my culture. It's not fun to be in my culture sometimes, but still, it's fun to be me. So, who knows? Thanks for listening in. Bye.